All right, guys, we're back on CLT, practice test number one, moving forward to question number 84. And it says, if box is defined such that x box y equals 2x minus 3y, which of the following is equivalent to negative 2 box 2? So when I look at this, I see this box, and this is just giving us a little something to almost, I want to say, make it look more difficult than it is. So when I see that I have a negative 2 in front of the box over here, and then I see that over here, I have my x in front of the box. It's just telling me that where I have an x in this little expression here, 2x minus 3y, to put a negative 2 in for my x. So that's 2 times negative 2 for the x minus 3. And then for the y, we have a 2 behind the box, and the y is behind the box, so that's telling me to put it in a positive 2 for the y. And then we can continue working on this. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. And then these are both positive with a minus sign. 3 times 2 is 6. And our last step here to solve the expression is negative 4 minus 6. Both signs are negative. So my answer is going to be negative. And then you can just do what with those numbers? Just add them up. 4 plus 6, 10. And there's our answer. And now, moving forward to question number 85. A wedding reception has 16 round tables and is set up for 126 guests. After the guests are all seated, every table is filled except for one, which has 2 open spaces. How many chairs are at each table? How many chairs at each table? So wedding reception, banquet hall, there's 16 tables. We have 126 guests and 2 open spaces. What am I going to do with those 126 guests plus 2 open spaces for additional guests? Additional, we're going to add them, right? So we have 126 guests plus space for 2 more gives us 128 total chairs. So 16 tables can have how many chairs at each table if there's 128 chairs, right? Or 128 spots. So the least amount of chairs it would be 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if we took 16 times 7, right? Because really we want to take this 128, oops, and divide it by 16. And we'll start checking here at 7. 16 can't go into 1. 16 can't go into 2. So how close do we get here with this? 7 times 6, 42. 7 times 1, 7 plus 4, 11. So 7's not quite it. I'm going to make a little T chart here on the side, a number times 16. We got 7 times 16 is 112. If I just add 16 to this number right here, then I'll have my next number. And what's 112 plus 16? 6 plus 2. 1 plus 1. ding, 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 I see a match. So this is telling us that if there's 128 chairs or spots for chairs and there's 16 tables, we can evenly have 8 chairs at every table. And then we'll move on to question number 86. A student goes to a job fair. At the job fair, 27 companies are offering summer internships, while 42 companies are offering part-time jobs. No company is offering both summer internships and part-time jobs. If by the time the student shows up, 3 of the companies offering summer internships have filled all their positions. 3 companies with the summer internships filled their positions. What is the ratio of companies offering summer internships to companies offering part-time jobs? So I want to know this ratio. And you notice while I was reading it, I went ahead and I color-coded my keywords at the same time. So everything that has to do with a summer internship, I made this orange color. So we started with 27 companies, but 3 of the companies filled their position. So 27 and 3, what are we going to do with those numbers? Subtract them. So we got 24 companies offering a summer internship, and then 42 offering part-time jobs. That was the purple information. So 24 to 42. And looking at these numbers, we want to say, okay, these two numbers can both be divided by what? Because we got our ratio and our answer is not here. So 24 and 42. You've got some options, some different numbers you could divide by. You could divide 24 and 42 both by 2 and you'd get an answer. Both of these numbers are also divided by 3. And you'd get a different answer. And if you remember your divisibility rules, if a number can be divided by both 2 and by 3, then those numbers can both be divided by 6. So I'm going to choose to divide by 6 since that's the biggest number. So divide this number by 6 and divide this number by 6. 24 divided by 6 is 4, and 42 divided by 6 is 7. And we found our match. So that one is done.